Hello and welcome to another episode of Alicia Rising's Faction Actions on the Explorers of Elsewhere channel. Hello, hi, I am DM Dan, and we're gonna dive into what the factions have been up to in the aftermath of episode 8, which in itself was like a bumper downtime session for the players, given all of the many meanings of the word heat that was accrued over the space of the Ruby Keep score. We established in episode 8 that approximately a week has been and gone since the tragic, devastating events at the Ruby Keep, which culminated in the death of Marshal Algarve. And as we've seen, the players themselves have been busy, and therefore so have the factions. So, we're going to, kind of dive in, have a little look, see what they've been up to. There's quite a lot new on this page. It seemed kind of appropriate that a lot of plans were disrupted with what is effectively the start of the second act, this new chapter. And in terms of the kind of reputation clocks, surprisingly, I was kind of mulling this over. Surprisingly, I feel like not a whole lot really has changed. The crew have gained 1 point of reputation with the marionettes specifically, on thanks to a job well done. Job well done. And they're already at max, like a max plus 3 with the Underworld, so that's not going to change. Whilst the City Watch and the Blackguard were definitely troubled by the crew's actions, I'm going to just go ahead and say anyone that did witness what happened, what the crew were up to, probably aren't really in a position to do anything about it right now, so there we are. And then the other factions have just kind of been relatively neutral from the party's actions. I suspect quite a few of the factions are somewhat more grumpy with the Kindling specifically, but that's kind of happening in the background anyway. Anyway, in terms of these progress clocks then, as we can see in comparison to last time where a lot of them were completed, now new clocks are starting. Some of the clocks that were in progress I've restarted to reflect the sudden change in direction that the factions would be taking in the aftermath of the Ruby raising. So for example, the City Watch, the disparate war bands are now kind of vying for power amongst one another as a new leader slowly kind of rises to the top of that kind of meat pile. We also noticed that like the four main sub-factions within the other four factions, so the Marionettes, the Chainbearers, the Children of Aya, and the Kindling, they've all kind of pivoted in kind of response to the power vacuum. Something I'm also doing here, you can see on screen kind of what everyone's up to. I've decided to not kind of hide that. By the time this comes out, the players have already kind of gone through it and seen kind of interacted with what's what, so I don't mind kind of letting you as the audience know what's going on behind the curtain, much as you would see what was happening, what the villains and the deutagonists were doing in the background. Think of it as a behind the scenes elsewhere in Alicia, but just for you. One other handy bit about kind of you as the viewer knowing what's going on, I can roll these kind of in time, so you can see that I'm being very genuine with what the factions are doing and like how well they're doing. But yeah, I will kind of shout out what the various factions are doing as we go ahead and roll them. So, first things first, we'll start with the Guard, the three factions of the Guard, so the City Watch, the Blackguard, and the EIC. Starting with the City Watch first and foremost, so currently they are working on kind of finding a new leader to rally them together, to put down all of the ne'er-do-wells that are running amok in the city. They're still, surprisingly, a tier 3 faction. They're not as strong as they were, but they are still tier 3. So how well are they going to do? Not very well at all. Not very well at all. So that is one segment for a 3 on the dice. The Blackguard. Now, they are still a tier 6 faction. They're weakened again, but how well are they going to secure the keep? That is a success. So, 3 segments of their 6 clock here. What it is they're doing, whilst they were securing the keep originally, now securing the keep probably takes a slightly different approach. So, they've had to kind of restart. But they are halfway through their securing of the keep. And what they're up to once they've secured it, we'll find out as and when. Last but not least, the EIC. They are still a tier 3. They kind of weren't affected too much by the raising of the Ruby Keep. So they are still tier 3. And they are attempting to unmask the leader of the Marionettes. And they have had some partial success with that. Obviously, the Marionettes, the whispers on the shadows being that the Marionettes were the ones that orchestrated the attack on the Keep. So therefore, if you unmask the linchpin, the kingpin of the Marionettes, then you can unravel that whole faction. So, 2 out of 6 segments for the EIC towards that. Speaking of the Marionettes, let's go ahead and have a look at what the Underworld is getting up to. There they are. So, the Marionettes are a tier 3. So they now, for reasons that they may or may not have discussed, they are currently looking for the source of the veil. That's what Songbird seems to be putting her attention to. They are tier 3. And how well have they been doing? They got a 6. That is 3 segments on the finding the source of the veil. So 3 out of 6 there. Meanwhile, the Cobbles, who've recently upgraded themselves to tier 2 now that they've taken, kind of got a foot in Old Town. They have been tasked by Songbird to perform the Bell Tower Prison Break to free all of those Sanguivar. And I mean, because the Sanguivar would be very grateful to whoever breaks them out of prison now that, the guard have been caught with their pants down a little bit. The Cobbles now, a tier 2. There, Musto has dropped the ball. Clearly, strategic planning is not that sweaty little goblin's forte. Perhaps he might approach the crew to see if they can help at some point in the future. Meanwhile, the Ilneishi. So they, when they completed their last clock, they successfully infiltrated a faction, one of their rival factions. Who that faction is yet to be seen, but they're going to attempt to infiltrate another. They are a tier 3. And they get a success. Clearly, in the confusion and the chaos of the raising of Ruby Keep, they've been able to get their fingers in new pies. The cheeky little scamps. Next up, we have the Pillars. So, the crew have been quite chummy with the Pillars. So let's start with the Chainbearers, see what they're getting up to. So Odalmerc, true to his word, having discussed this with Algonon, they are looking to build a replacement for the Veil, which they know, Odalmerc knows, is failing. It would seem that this is being referred to as the Shroud. So they are a tier 3. Let's see how they're doing. A 5, partial success. So work is beginning. They are at 2 out of 8 segments on their clock. Meanwhile, the Tellers, freshly embroiled in new conflict with the upstart Cobbles that are kind of impressing themselves upon the streets of Old Town. They are attempting to oust the interlopers from Old Town. Let's see how they get on. not very well at all. However, they have got the benefit of time on their side, as we can see, the cobbles are currently preoccupied with the Bell Tower prison break. Next up, Lodge Reticent. So, they are attempting to usurp power and control, which seems appropriate given all of the, as I say, the chaos and the carnage after episode 7. They are a tier 2. How well are they doing? A 5 is a partial success, so they get 2 segments on their clock. That's 2 of 6. Okay, and that's the pillars done. Next up, the Children of Aya. Leaders of the faith. So, if anyone were to look, were to ask, were to snoop, they would discover that the Children of Aya are preparing for the summoning. And quite what the summoning is, I'm going to leave secret, but at least you know you have that juicy little plot hook dangling in your minds. So, that's a new 8 clock for them. They are still a tier 4. Let's see how they're doing. 6. Very good. So, that is 3 segments of their 8 clock as they prepare for the summoning. The Shield of Alicia. So, they've seemingly been kind of oblivious as to what's been going on. They are doggedly chasing down their investigation on the ghosts that happened up at Amringer, all the way back in episode 4, episode 4, when a ghost was wrenched through the veil. They're still searching for that. Let's see how they're getting on. 6, which means 3 segments completes their clock. They have successfully investigated the ghosts, and we will see how that pans out as they discover what it is they need to discover in a future episode. Lastly, the Garden Keepers, the dear old Garden Keepers, they finished their clock in the run into episode 7, which was actually the same goal, the same task that they're now trying to achieve. So the strange viney roots that burst out of the ground and encapsulated the keep and kind of stopped it from completely crumbling, that was a direct result of the Garden Keepers propagating the secret grove that they are tending to, and clearly they had a bit of a breakaway success which caused that massive explosion of primal divine magic that caused that rampant natural growth. And now they've done it once, so why not do it again? They're going to propagate. They get a 4, so that is 2 segments on their 6 clock. So 2 of 6 segments for the Garden Keepers. Okay. And now, some would call them the Champions of the Hour, but let's have a look at what the Forsworn are getting up to. So, the Kindling. They've been busy bees, just taking names left, right, and centre. Now, the Kindling are a tier 2 faction. They, it apparently, are also attempting to find the source of the veil. But we can imagine that their ambitions with it are slightly less altruistic than some of the other factions. So how well are they doing on that front? A 6. So that is 3 segments of the 8 in their attempt to find the veil. Okay, next up, the Hollow. So the Hollow have also kind of kept themselves ferreted away, busying themselves with their gruesome experiments. It would seem that they are currently occupied with obtaining test subjects. And they, you know, they're no need to restart their work. They can kind of carry on as is. They are tier 2. Let's see how they get on. They have rolled a 3, so that is only 1 more segment, so they're yet to obtain any more test subjects, but that does take them up to 5 of 6 on their progress clock. And last but not least, The last time we had a look at these, the orchestra completed the clock, the progress clock. I can confirm that the orchestra was, that the goal of the orchestra was to add to the cacophony. And the cacophony was successfully added to. Successfully enough that they're going to do it again. So, two dice as I look for more. Six, that is three segments. Okay, so they're already halfway through their clock to add to the cacophony, whatever that may mean. So that is pretty much it. That's where our clocks lie now. So the Shield of Alesia, slow off the starting blocks, but they've finally kind of come to the end of their investigations about the ghost being pulled through the veil. And I'm sure that's absolutely not going to come and bite the crew on the arse. But yeah, the clocks are now kind of moving forward. We can see that the main kind of the leader factions seem to be moving towards some sort of definitive end goal for each of them. And whilst we kind of know what's happening, we'll see how the crew's actions affect these clocks kind of positively or negatively as they do more scores over the upcoming episodes. So that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching. If you're intrigued by what's going on here, and you want to see how some of these kind of this slew of roles affects the actual play itself, make sure to check out the Alesia Rising campaign its entirety. We've just started the second act and things are really kind of heating up and speeding up now. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and comment down below, and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon for notifications of when we release new videos, because we release them very frequently and we don't want you to miss out. So with all that said, thank you, see you soon.